What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Full Game Walkthrough Series, episode 153. Today, we start our journey with a new mount, a new transmog. So let me show you. This is the Ankylosaurus. Somewhat of a goon, I'll be honest. He's a little bit... he's a champion in his own right. And then... Let's unequip him real quick. And we have a giant banner to slap people with. And then I have the banana roots gear. Midnight approves. She's a little bit spooked, but who wouldn't be? The beautiful waterfalls from Alto Alto. Last time, well, I defeated some extra spirit people. Today... we are going to be getting, hopefully, sharpen and potent, right? 86. So let's get things started. Let me equip my boss deck on. We're going to make some changes. We're going to use Basilisk today. Change things up a bit. But hopefully everybody's enjoying their Friday. Finally Friday. I'm telling you, this week, it's been a struggle. But hopefully the week back to school, everybody's doing well. I think things are okay. Let's just put in one pixie instead of three satyr. That'd be kind of fun. Our TC's okay. Let's put an extra couple. I also talked to McMuffin. Got some extra spirit blade TC's. I'm low on gold, so I'll have to farm later. And also I'm thinking about, oh, we have three training points. We're getting 86 today or bust. I mean, it is happening. Nothing else. We're getting it. Alrighty, he's life. I think everything is good, right? Yep, we have no feints. Alright, here we go.
Welcome to my jaws.
Alrighty. Time to defeat him. Pretty cool looking cave. Similar to the other one. Alright. Fair amount of health. Move that. We'll shield. Sound seems a little bit low today. Bum 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 bum. What are you using? Fair enough. Oh, back to you! I really do look like a goober in this gear, don't I? It's okay. You don't need double of that. We'll blade up. Double blade! Blade and faint. Yeah, should kill him. He's setting up. They're both setting up. Oh gosh. Well, we don't want to give him extra boost. Well, we drew it anyway. Alright, we'll faint him. GG on the storm guy next. This banner. Like, literally, it could slap someone. It's like... Oh my gosh, I've had the banners in the past on my death character, but I never really had it as a mog. It's kind of fun. You like spin it. Instead of using spells, we'll just slap them with it. That should be GG. On the storm guy, not the boss. Not by any means. There we are. Time to use Basilisk. I'm excited. Looks like he's sneezing. Like, what? I guess. Alright. So we have the Colossal Basilisk. We don't need double Time of Legend. We'll keep both feints, because feints are going to be key here, team. Let's pop Time of Legend, get that out of the way. There we are. Now I feel in a more comfortable area. It's kind of weird, though, like, in this bubble, eyes are floating everywhere, like, oh, you see me? Like, it's it's a little bit odd, but it makes sense. Somewhat. I mean, for myth, anyway. Myth standards. But if you're, like, a fire wizard, you come over here. I mean, for every bubble, it's kind of funny, though. Like, the fire, it's probably, like, tens of thousands of degrees inside. Everybody's sweating. The ice one, everybody's, like, below, like, a billion degrees, freezing. Whoa! It's fine, so there you are. Pretty good spell for him to use. Prime time. And then, like, every bubble has its own thing. And then balance. I don't really know what the environment would be for balance. I guess everything would just seem okay because everything's equal, like, balanced. I don't know. That's something you have to ask Alhazared. Bum, 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 bum. Okay. Well. If we could draw the, there we go. Alright, now I'm gonna start the feints. We're doing okay on health. We are doing okay. There we go. We won't need that. We'll faint. We need to do a lot of feints. I'm probably three. At least three. Pretty sure three. More, not two. Two's too little. Pretty sure three. That bass whenever he just like shoots off the arrow. Pretty intense. Not within a tent, but pretty intense. Well, since Pixie showed up, I think that's a good thing to have here. We'll use Pixie to stay afloat. Critical on a heal? What? And I can't even crit on a hit? Whoa. Okay. Well. More faints. We'll put on two for now, and then we'll save up to then hit with Basilisk, and we'll put one on after the dots are rolling in. I think that'll be a great plan. Reliquary, and then hit. I think that's the way it'll be. It should be GG. I mean, I haven't used Basilisk in a while. I'm really looking forward to it. Hello, old friend. Funny seeing you in a dinosaur-filled world, even though you're... Well, you're a hybrid, really. Mythical hybrid. The critical? Is it real? Oh, yeah. I guess three feints. It's my bad. Three feints on him before we hit, because they're too different. Yeah. It's my bad. But... hopefully you'll forgive me. Have you used it in a while? Yeah, that did 4,000. So that would have did 13,000 some. For yeah, okay, so four feints total for boss of 20k. That's good to know. That's amazing. Actually really convenient, too. Just fighting one boss. That's a lot. Would have been dead if I would have had the feint already on him. Well, not dead yet, but... Well, actually, yeah, I think he would have been dead, yeah, if I would have had that feint on. Or very close to. I can't really math right now. Well, there you are. That was fun.
Don't turn me into boots!
Into crocodile boots. I get it. Oh, yeah, we gotta use the altar. Are we ready for this? Maybe. I don't know.
You drop the prickly pear cactus pulp upon the altar. It has a sweet and syrupy smell. There is a song of a howling wind rushing through the cave. When it silences, you see a stone inscribed with an emblem waiting for you. The emblem glyph has a picture of a huge waterfall with a tall stone pillar beside it.
Interesting. Well, I wonder where that... I guess the breeze came through the cave's mouth, the opening. Alright, let's equip the new mount. A little bit of a goon, but let's be honest. Kind of need that peppiness in our step for the rest of Azteca. Onyx, what do we got, my friend? We're getting stuck! There we go. We have to go down this whirlpool.
You got the emblem glyph.
You don't say.
Take the emblem glyph to the Cloudbearer pedestal. You will see a groove where you place it. It will raise the sky pillar. Climb up quickly, and don't look down. I'll meet you up top.
Sounds good, my friend. Well, team, we're raising up. Almost level 86 hype. Pretty sure we have to talk to Bacall as well, so. Oh yeah, this is the giant pillar. All right, here we go. We're summoning the beast!
The emblem glyph fits perfectly into the groove on the cloud bearer pedestal. There's a deep, low grinding. The sound is something you can barely hear, but it resonates in your bones.
Oh, we just start floating.
The sky lurches up into the clouds. Something that huge should not move so quickly.
Alrighty. Well, we're going up the sky pillar. Welcome to Alto Alto, the place where we can craft some gear and all that good stuff. That little cobweb right there that's like shadow infused, question mark, can't remember. Take the pedal door, then we go to the floating mountains, twin giants, boo-boo. Yeah, so we're moving, team. We're moving. The beautiful waterfalls. Let's level up.
You made it. Quite the view, hmm?
Yep.
The Shadow Queen's forces are strong here, as her attention is focused on the Avian King. Fight some of the beak-breakers who have gone over to the Shadow to get the lay of the land. Branches.
Well, we'll do that after. We'll leave a mark here. Six of these people, huh? Fire. Let me go check and see what level for the crafting again. Once again, very fuzzy. 86 to 88, question mark. Not 88, there's no way. Has to be 86. So we can go see. People say that the boots for block, or... Oh, yeah, he doesn't show up yet. Oh, yeah, he's normally is like right here. Maybe you have to get him in quest, yeah. Okay, never mind. Okay, let's go back to... the Zocolo. Zocolo. However you pronounce it. The Sakulu of sorts. We're moving. Yeah, defeat 6. That's pretty crazy. Last no surroundings. Bacall. I'll know the quest when I see it.
Tezca Freestar told me you restored the Star School Obelisk in 3 points. Now we must try to restore the Sun School Obelisk. A group of ignoble Monquistans came to 3 points while the Aztecosaurs still dwelled in the cenote and raided the city. They pried the solar shards out of the Sun School Obelisk. Now it will not awaken. Go to their ship in the Salt Meadow Marsh. Speak to Ponce de Gibbon, their leader. He must surrender the solar shards to you. Bring the solar shards back to me here, and we will see if we can make the sun come back up.
You have to fight him again? I don't remember that. That's interesting. There we are. Oh, not that many. I think what we'll do for every ep, we'll like mix it up. We'll use like Basilisk and or Medusa, but when we get the calendar, of course, we'll use the calendar and just change it up. Go between those spells, keep things spicy. This dinosaur moves kind of uniquely. He's just so excited to start questing. And there was a teleporter back there, wasn't there? Yep. Well, made that mistake. We're moving, though.
Alrighty.
Well, yeah, there's the teleporter. We're back in the salty swamp. Whew. Gotta be careful. We do not want to get pulled. Ponce!
Solar shards? On that matter, wizard, I have only a little to say to you. True, certain Monkistans stole these solar shards from your San Obelisk, but they did not do this on my order. Those who did this theft fell out of favor. They have taken refuge in the glade of the Poison Dart Frog in Mangrove Marsh. Their leader is Clemente Moraga, a no-account villain and scoundrel. Defeat him, and you will have your solar shards. If you should see some other gold or treasure piled about, pay it no heed. It plays no part in your story. Ah, wizard, you bring good... Go and talk to Mr.
Easy,
Bly, and
Ponce.
Sort it out for me, yes? I'll reward you with many golden bananas.
Golden bananas? Sounds too good to be true. Okay, let's make our way around here. Please, thank you. Yeah, there's Boo Boo. She's on the horizon! Well, we're moving. I'm trying to remember if this boss cheats. I don't know. I don't remember. Like I say, I mean, I don't really like to know beforehand. I just kind of go in without knowing the majority of stuff because I did it so long ago. I know this is a solo get 'em good. If it's more than one boss, we'll have to summon
Did
minions.
Did Ponce de Gibbon send you to challenge me for leadership of our band? A rich jest! Ha! Men, let us send this one packing.
Yeah, I don't think this guy cheats, but I think he's pretty difficult. I remember this. We're going to put in an extra pixie. Take out this. Put in volcanic shields. I think that'll be good, right? TC's good. Yeah. I think everything's good. Alright. Debating wish. I think I'll put a minion in. Excuse me. Should I? I mean, he'll take aggro, but the other guy does blades. Or, I mean, Talos. We'll put in a couple of Talos, huh? Why not? That's a lot of health. That is a lot of health. Alright, well. See if we can do this. Whoa. Midnight starting things off fresh. That's the most important. Let's be honest with ourselves. Excuse me. Okay, well, we don't need that. We don't need that. I think the best bet that we have right now, team. Yeah, the time I don't want to get double spirit blade. We're gonna faint both of these people. I mean, if Midnight's healing, I feel confident. Because I know at least double blade with faint is necessary. Yeah, so. It's not too much of a worry. The only worry I kind of have, I don't know. It's really not much. It's not much of a worry I have right now. gonna try and focus, team. Plus 40. We need to find, Myth Blade. And then the Spirit Blade. This is okay. If Midnight heals in 2 to 3 rounds, we should be okay. Generally speaking. The spell does sure take a while, though. I guess the only thing is, like, if they keep... Well, like, they heat turned up, right? Dot, 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 dot. I don't think it's too much of a worry right now. We're still at a lot of health. We still have a lot of health. Okay, remove that. Let's put on the plus 35. Whoa. That's another thing that I completely forgot to do today was put in Cleanse Charm. I swear I was gonna do it. I knew I was missing something the entire ep. Yep. Well, not for this battle. Just Cleanse Charm in general. Just have one Cleanse Charm for emergency reasons. So hopefully we find that in the future. Slightly worried, but not too worried. I need to use this and bank on that I get, but I don't think I actually have... Do I have the wand hit up still? We're just going to use this, because I don't want to use... I do not want to not use anything. That makes sense, somewhat. Alrighty, welcome back, everyone. So, I didn't die. I fled. And I quit out. Went to the bazaar, bought some Cleanse Charm. This time he didn't use Ifrit at all. So that's RNG for that part. Another part of this fight that, for everybody, looked online as well. If you're a fire wizard, of course, mass prism and whatnot. For myth, couldn't find anything but recommend frog. Double blade with feint should do the trick. So that's that. They do have 3,500 health, so keep that in mind. So you do have to blade up. It is solo, no friends helping. That's another thing. Have heals in. This is the fight. I just got done defeating the two minions with Humongo Frog. I had a heal twice. Midnight healed once. So this battle's a little bit difficult, but not too difficult. It normally takes one or two times. Make sure you have Cleanse Charm in. So yeah, that's that. There it is. Let's use Spirit Blade. I see the gold in the background that Ponce was talking about. And also, there's another strat that I looked online. You can't leave a mark in here. I don't know if that was different a while back, but you could, which was years ago. But when this world came out, like 3 years ago, back in 2012. But you can't. I don't think we'll need... Well, I'll keep the Cleanse Charm, let's be honest. I don't know if I'll need it or not. Draw. We have to faint. A little bit low on health as well, but we'll pixie. Hopefully Midnight heals as well. That'd be helpful. So we have the Spirit Blade, the plus 40 blade, the 35 blade, double faint. Should be GG soon. I don't think anything else, really. We just have to wait till Medusa. But we are going to heal. It's very important. elephant. Fizzle. At least we kept the charm. Casey got antsy. I guess we'll stack blades. Wouldn't hurt. Dragon. There we are. Block, thank you. That would have been terrible. That would have been really terrible if we didn't block. Time of legend. Worth. We're gonna pass. 2, 4. 2, 4. 5, 6. Combat next. Is it worth? Yeah, I think it's worth. I mean, it's close to the wire, but it is very important to do this. I mean, you have to get the spells, which are so, I mean, that is like, when you have to, how important it is on a scale of 1 to 10, it's a 10. I mean, things get close to the wire, but it's the way it is. GG, my friend. Low on that health, Midnight, if you could get fluent, please. Somehow we pull a miracle, though, to be honest. We crit the first time. No crit this time, though. Rest in pepperonis, mate. So there you are.
Those solar shards were our downfall. I should have listened to all those stories of cursed Aztecan gold.
You search the crates and find several pieces of hammered gold. These must be the solar shards.
We take some extra gold so we can, What was that sound? What? All right, let's go back to the Zocalo. Yeah, I mean, that was a close battle. Didn't die the first time. I was gonna die. I was, trust me. But then I realized, yeah, Cleanse Charm is a must nowadays. I don't even know why I haven't had that in there. Anyway, Bacall. A lot of bugs.
Those are the solar shards. I cannot imagine why someone took them. Were their words of the curse not clear enough? No matter. You must now restore them to the Sun School Obelisk. Be at it now.
Oh, trust me, I am. Over here?
The solar shards slip into place, almost disappearing among the other decorative emblems. The Sun School Obelisk begins to get warm, almost hot. You can feel the magic energy radiate from it.
Amazing. Let's talk to Bacall. You gotta hear it too, it's like... something. Bacall!
You have done it! 2 of the 3 astral obelisks are now awakened, their secret power restored! Zaylin Reedwalker seeks a way to unlock the last, the Moon School Obelisk. She will summon you when she needs your assistance.
59,000 XP, team. Well, let's train into him, huh? Okay. Potent. So important. Amazing. You gotta love it. Sharpen. Oh gosh, we finally have it. Is it real? Am I dreaming? Primordial is one of those that... death. You enchant those and then use Primordial, I can't remember how that goes. I'm pretty sure, yeah, then you get them for PvP or something like that. I don't know. What else? Oh yeah! Well, first off, let's put in... well, since we have 3... so, for the difference, we'll have 2 or 1. We'll learn how many we actually need. But for blades, I'll put in 3. So, yeah. That's that. And we'll also... well, yeah, we'll keep Medusa in, and then we'll do Basilisk next. Or, after that, next time. Let's put in our... check our attack deck. Put in... where's the set? There it is. 2 of those. Well, there we are. Let's go... Well, let's go leave a mark in Alto Alto, huh? And then we'll go learn reshuffle. Let's go learn that, huh? We got one more training point. There's a port somewhere, isn't it? I don't have all the ports memorized. I'm pretty sure nobody does. Somewhere around here, but... I think it was on the pyramid. About the same length, traveling. The Ankylosaurus is pretty... Well, it's not as loud as the T-Rex. It's always, like, the loudest. Let's see where this is at so we know for the future. Oh, it's right here. That's a facepalm. That's a failfish. Alright. Well, we're moving. Well, I cannot actually believe we have it, but we do. It is a Christmas miracle in January. We finally have Sharpen and Potent. So important. So yeah, that battle with Clemente might take you one or two times, maybe even three. It's just the way it goes. The RNG the second time didn't get Ifrit, and also didn't have Clench Charm the first time. My mistake. So yeah, let's leave a mark up here. So next time, I'll have these guys defeated, and then we'll start our journey in Alto Alto, figure out how we get the crafting guy. Pretty sure he's like through the quest and...